6 foot in the old, 203 pounds at 31 years of age, giving a bit away in age. He gives 5 years to Stan the Man Longanides. Let's go centre ring to Howard Lee.
The World Heavyweight Championship title. The judges at ringside from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, United States of America, Robert Hill. From Vancouver, Canada, the WKA president, Dale Floyd. From Melbourne, Australia, your third judge, Joe Lanciano. Your referee for the main event, from Gilroy, California, United States of America, Mr. Art True. Mr. Robert Hill will sanction this bout. Your ringside position Dr. Peter Lewis, timekeeper, stepping up for his sixth world kickboxing title, Bronson Sitdown. Promoter Chris Curtis and ring announcer Howard Lee. Your point supervisor, Craig Larson.
Well, one thing I will say, Richard, I don't think I've seen Stan as tight as what I've seen him tonight.
He's in nice shape.
He's trimmed right up.
He's done us in the world of good.
He's trimmed right up.
I want to mention again that this main event will be fought under ISKA Oriental rules, and it's sanctioned by the ISKA for the World Heavyweight title. And the judge at the ringside for the main event at ringside, the judges at ringside will be Robert Heal from Fort Lauderdale, Dale Floyd from Vancouver, Canada, and Joe Lanciano from Melbourne, Australia. The ISKA referee for the main event is Art True from San Jose, California, USA.
Well, all I can say is, Richard Norton, you've had a chance to see Alexio before. I haven't. And this crowd here in Melbourne. What's Alexio on about in the corner? We'll try and go over and have a listen in a moment. But this crowd here in Melbourne, they're caught up in the euphoria of this. Dana Goodson there at the moment, as he's, I think there's a bit of a dispute at the moment over the gloves.
As I said, an interesting thing with Dennis.
Right around the world, 100 countries, 100 million people.
Just been going on for some time. The other interesting thing too, Rob, with this is the height of both these fighters are pretty equal in height.
Yeah.
Most of them have fought much taller opponents. Dennis with his overhand right catches those taller opponents, and Stan, of course, with his jumping left hook. Catches them. It's going to be interesting that they're on the same level, and that same tactic is not going to work the same way.
Well, Alexio, give him credit. He's, as you said before, he's called for foot pads because the power of Longanides is definitely the feet.
The other thing, of course, Dennis is a wonderful infighter. You know, he's going to use that right rip to the body, and he uses that really just to get the person's attention because he really wants to drive that uppercut, and he's very quick with that, and you'll see that a lot. Stan used a knee to the old crazy sort of cover-up to combat that. As I said, you see that right rip followed by the uppercut from Alexio, and it's a very effective weapon for him. But like I said, they don't realize they underestimate Stan's boxing ability. I've seen him get it on with Mike Weaver, with Tucker over there. These guys are monsters over in the Jet Center, and he can take a punch. And this is going to be a war, but I think the first five rounds is going to completely decide this whole thing. And I think Dennis is going to try and take Stan out in the very early round. Stan knows that, so you're going to see two fighters just going at it toe-to-toe.
Well, I don't know whether you heard the rumors that I did around here earlier this afternoon. As we said, the war of words began through the week at a lot of the press conferences. I saw another side of Stan Longanides I've never seen before, and I also saw another side of Alexio. Now they're about to get it on here down in the Glass House or the Entertainment Center here in Victoria. But the good mail tells me that Alexio is going to try and put Stan out in under five rounds.
Yes, he's going to try and prove a point.
Now, should we say the educated money says yes, it's going to be under five rounds? But the Aussie, not to be undaunted.
We're ready to rumble with our main event. In the blue corner, originally from California, now based in Honolulu, Hawaii. 55 bouts, 54 wins, 59 knockouts. Regarded universally as the man to beat in kickboxing. At 33 years of age, scaling 92 kilograms, 14 stone, 7 pounds. Tantalizing tormentor of tenacity, this, the Terminator, Alexio! Alexio! Alexio!
Boy, he looks strong, Bob, doesn't he? To build on the guy. There's only a kilogram difference in weight, you know, but looking at it, you wouldn't know it, except you look at Stan's legs and how solid he is in that lower region.
2 inches in height.
As I said, though, I think Dennis is going to try and prove a point. He really wants to show that Stan is not worthy of anything, and it's going to be interesting how quickly
Dennis, a little agitated in the corner, keeping on the move around Stan, very cool, calm.
Well, that's just Dennis's mode anyway. I mean, as you say, a lot of it's psychology.
Sure.
At the beginning of the fight, he just wants to show that he's there to fight. He's going to control the center of the ring, and that's what it's all about.
We said before, the perfect athlete. graduated in 1977 from Bankerville High School as High School Athlete of the Year. He's captain football, basketball, and baseball. And was
father and mother, Susie and Steve Longanitas.
Was also, as Howard Lee is saying, that Steve Longanitas is dedicating this fight to his mum and dad. And the Melbourne crowd are gearing up for their hero. Listen to the roar at the Glasshouse.
That's great, you know, this crowd's got to get behind him, man.
I said to you, I think just about every Greek in Melbourne's here tonight. I love him. And let's not kid ourselves, there's a few of us Aussies too, not that we're saying the Greeks aren't Australians, we're taking it to our heart as well.
Of course we can, of course we have.
Stan Longanitas, good luck tonight. Dennis Alexiou, good luck to you too. May the best man win, because we're going to see something tonight downtown.
This
down
is going
under,
to be a war
that we've never seen before.
As I said, fight of the century.
All time. Since the break, we'll step back and fight. Not roll on the inside, fight out. Good luck.
Judges from right around the world. Judge in center ring gets the crowd moving. Our referee also with the bow tie, very resplendent.
10-3 minute round.
Richard Norton, how do you see it? I'll put you right on the spot.
I'm not going to even predict that. All I know is it's going to be a war. I mean, experience-wise, with the amount of fights Alexiou's had, you've got to give him that. He's very cool, he's very strong. But this is half an hour out of Stan's life, as he told me, he's going to give it everything he's got.
And the grass court stays on.
And 3 minute rounds, of course, even though they fight all the time for 3 minute rounds in the gym, it's going to be interesting. Is Stan going for those leg kicks there? Dennis covering up though. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. What's happened here?
I reckon he's done an Achilles.
He's done his head. Dennis is down.
Oh, do not believe what I see.
He's done his leg. He's done his leg. They're sending Stan over the neutral corner.
Oh,
he's broken it. Dennis, I saw Dennis mouthing that he's broken it. He feels like he's broken it.
Decorum in the center ring at the moment. We didn't want to see this happen. But he toppled over backwards.
Flat on his back at the moment. Look at Stan.
And in absolute agony.
Stan is almost crying in the center right now. He can't believe it. Stan's in tears. Stan is in tears. I've got to see a replay of what actually happened.
We can get a camera down to Longanitas at the moment. Here we go. Stan Longanitas has been hailed the winner of Rockhop.
People everywhere in the seats.
This is just... I mean, how do you describe something like this? My heart goes out at the moment for Alexiou. But it's pandemonium center ring here at the moment. Here we go. Let's have a look. We go back center ring. And they get it on from the word go. The left hand, the uppercut comes from Longanitas. The kick comes across the shin. There's the damage. There is the damage.
He topples backwards. Throwing and then he's stopping.
Oh. Everybody out, please.
I'm still not sure what. That leg kick surely wouldn't have done that.
Well, it came straight across the shin. It was a shin kick that came out of it. And it's thrown Alex. It's thrown Dennis. Here we go again. Let's have a little look, Richard.
We're looking at this replay. There's that nice shin kick. Kicks him on the lower ankle there. He did struggle on that.
Alexiou has a broken leg.
Whoa. Rob, did you
ever... I look, I'm dumbfounded, Richard. I know it's all very well to say early that we said that Longanitas' power is definitely in his kicking. But that was the kick that did the damage. But oh, no, I know.
Ladies and gentlemen, the official verdict, because Dennis Alexiou was injured during combat, the new undisputed champion of the world.
Championship for Stan Longanitas.
Well,
I mean, he's ecstatic, but
I'm sure that's not the way Stan would love to have won the fight. But then again, you turn around the other way, and who's to say the same thing wouldn't have happened to him? They're both in there.
Anything can happen, that's it. Look at this.
Well, Stan Longanitas, congratulations. Well, oh, gee, my heart goes out for the Terminator. Never before have we seen a fighter come across to this country with a record of this man, of Dennis Alexio. And to be put down in that way. And I say put down in that way, I mean, all fair and love and war, a great kick from Stan Long and Edie's. It's still pandemonium here in centre ring. But at the moment, we've really got to get Dennis out of that ring. Our cameras cannot even get in there at the moment. Here we go again, Richard. Let's have a look and see if we can see it from another angle. Now, keep your eye on the right leg of Stan's. There it is. Right on the shin. You can see the shin come down.
He put his leg down. Yeah, is the only one throwing anything right there.
And he's just... no weight can go on there whatsoever. There it goes.
That's where it goes.
Well, Stan Long and Edie's the new world champion. Shin kick as we go center ring, and the man with the most imposing record, Dennis Alexio, prone in center ring. What a sad sight. But it's the sport. And Doctor's in there at the moment, and his cornerman keeping the head elevated, taking the gloves off him. Here we go again.
Here we go. We're seeing this replay once again.
Here's Long and Edie's. The right leg comes across to meet the shin of Alexio. There it is. And meets contact. Alexio to put the foot to the ground. And no weight can be borne upon it.
Look at that. What a result. Well, that is, I can't believe what I've seen.
Dennis has a clear break to his leg. Very clear.
Well, Long and Edie's. I'd love to get him down here and have a chat with him at the moment, but we'll go center ring at the moment with Howard Lee, I'm sure. The crowd here also stunned.
Stan connects the kick on Dennis's shin, and he breaks the shin in half. And because he was during combat and it was a legal kick, it is a win for the Undisputed Heavyweight Championship of the World.
Well, the Golden Greek, Stan Long and Edie's, and...
what a happy man Stan is. As you said, I'm sure he would have seen the other way, but they're in combat, it was a legal kick, and that's the end of the story.
Well, it happened very, very quickly, and there's Stan over the top of Dennis now, and I don't think all the words that Stan could give him would probably mean much to Dennis at the moment. But, oh, gee, I would have loved to have seen this fight generate a little more, but we have seen some tremendous bounce here.
Carried out the stretcher.
Dennis Alexio leaves center ring as we still have pandemonium, we still have mayhem, as Stan Long and Edie's as well wishes gather in center ring, and we have the new undisputed heavyweight champion of the world from Taylor's Lakes in Victoria, Melbourne, Australia. Stan, the man, Long and Edie's. Let's hope we can get a microphone in there as quick as we can.
We're going to talk to Stan the man in just a moment.
Joyous faces, ecstatic supporters, can't believe what they've seen. Richard Norton and myself, we can't believe what we've seen either, but we've seen it on the replay. That's told the story, the picture told the story.
Yep, bring him across here. Everybody move back, please.
Okay, center ring, Howard Lee, our ring announcer with our new world champion.
Short but sweet. It's definitely the sweetest victory. I know people can get their money's worth, but let me just tell you this. I prepared myself in a big way for this fight, to be prepared focusedly, and in a big way. I knew I was in for a war, and I was prepared for 10 rounds, but let me just say a couple of things I really want to say. I couldn't have gotten here today with the people, without the people around me. I've got a great team of people, and all you people out there. Hey, let me tell you. Let me tell you, Dennis and I will fight again, because I cannot face myself in the mirror, and I'm not satisfied with that. I want people out there to get their money's worth, but this fight meant a lot to me, because I dedicated it to my mother and father, who I love very much. My father's here with me tonight. My mum, probably, as usual, she's at home
on the knees praying that I'm not getting hurt. I just want to say to you, all you people out there, that I couldn't have gotten here without all your support. And it's great to see a full arena, to see Dennis Alexia tonight. Dennis, I thank you very much for the opportunity. One last thing I want to say to all the kickboxing critics out there that didn't believe that I can do it. They can kiss my ass and look at me now.
That says it all, Rob.
Well, I always say, never argue with a man with a microphone. Well, well, all I can say is to you, wherever you may be watching this spectacular night of kickboxing here at the Glasshouse here in Melbourne, Victoria, I hope you've enjoyed it. A tremendous lead-up, a tremendous card.
What a tremendous card, I mean. I still don't know what to say, Rob. I still don't. But I say, our boy's there. He's a heavyweight champion. There will be a rematch.
We'll look back in time, Richard. We'll say 8,500 people that came here, the 2,500 that are gathered at the Metro nightclub down here in Melbourne, and also those other people that couldn't get in. 1,000 people tonight couldn't get in the doors here. And to me, we've never had that happen here to kickboxing, to this sport of kickboxing here in Melbourne.
Nope. And this is all happening in Melbourne, Australia.
And, you know, as he said, they will fight again. Fingers crossed that the break is not as bad as perhaps, well, any break's bad. But a clean break or a green stick, we don't know what it will be.
I know, that's it. It's going to be interesting to see
and
what
the unfortunate thing for Dennis, it's in the most vulnerable area.
I mean, definitely unfortunate for Dennis. He's, you know, Dennis is a real warrior, and, you know, you don't wish that on anybody, that's for sure.